left a comment under someone's YouTube video this morning that they named On My Spirit, David's Temple, Mount Zion to Vatican. And there's been some talk about Vatican taking control over Mount Zion or the top of Mount Zion or something to that effect. But I felt led to do a video about this to make some sense of this. So I'm going to go ahead and read most of the comment that I left under his video. A pretty long comment. I wrote, according to Hebrews chapter 12, Mount Zion, or Sion, depending on how it's spelled, is a mount that cannot be touched. Hebrews 12:18, for ye are not come unto the mount that might be touched, and that burned with fire, nor unto blackness and darkness and tempest. Hebrews 12:22, but ye are come unto Mount Sion, and unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels. And the heavenly Jerusalem, New Jerusalem, is a completely different city than Old Jerusalem, which is referred to spiritually as Sodom and Egypt, where our Lord was crucified. Revelation 11:8. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. Now let's consider what Paul says about these two different cities in Galatians 4:25 and 26. For this Agar is Mount Sinai in Arabia, and answereth to Jerusalem, which now is, and is in bondage with her children. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free, which is the mother of us all. Yes, old Jerusalem is in bondage with her children, but new Jerusalem is free. So these are obviously two completely different cities, according to Paul. So let's consider what happens to Old Jerusalem. And I know I've talked about these things before. A lot of you have seen these same verses I've used, but I feel led to drive this home because there are people who are looking at things in a carnal way, and they're not understanding this. So it says in Jeremiah 9:11, and I will make Jerusalem heaps and a den of dragons, and I will make the cities of Judah desolate without an inhabitant. Luke 21:20-22, and when ye shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies, then know that the desolation thereof is nigh. Then let them which are in Judea flee to the mountains, and let them which are in the midst of it depart out, and let not them that are in the countries enter thereinto. For these be the days of vengeance, that all things which are written may be fulfilled. The desolation is at hand when we see Jerusalem compassed with armies, like we do. And if God does not dwell in temples made with hands, like Isaiah and Paul tells us, then where is the abomination of desolation found? 1 Corinthians 3:17, if any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are. Yes, the abomination of desolation is found within the desolate. And according to Daniel, desolations, plural, are determined. So let's consider how the synagogue of Satan, who wants to rebuild Solomon's temple, suffers from what I call temple confusion. 1 Peter 2, verses 3 to 7. If so be ye have tasted that the Lord is gracious, to whom coming as unto a living stone, disallowed indeed of men, but chosen of God and precious, ye also as lively stones are built up a spiritual house, and holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God by Jesus Christ. Wherefore also it is contained in the Scripture, Behold, I lay in Sion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. Unto you therefore which believe he is precious, but unto them which be disobedient, the stone which the builders disallowed, the same is made the head of the corner. See what I'm saying? Masons, the builders, use what they call a cornerstone in the corner of their temples made with hands. Now let's consider who started all of this temple confusion. 1 Chronicles 21:1, and Satan stood up against Israel and provoked David to number Israel. 1 Chronicles 21:7, and God was displeased with this thing, therefore he smote Israel. And this David, who obviously did the will of Satan per scripture, said that Solomon would build God's house and courts in 1 Chronicles chapter 28, contrary to what God let David know in 2 Samuel chapter 7. 2 Samuel 7, verses 5 and 6, Go and tell my servant David, Thus saith the Lord, Shalt thou build me an house for me to dwell in? Whereas I have not dwelt in any house since the time that I brought up the children of Israel out of Egypt, even to this day, but have walked in a tent and in a tabernacle. 2 Samuel 7, 11 to 13. And as since the time that I commanded judges to be over my people Israel, and have caused thee to rest from all thine enemies, also the Lord telleth thee that he will make thee an house. And when thy days be fulfilled, and thou shalt sleep with thy fathers, I will set up the seed after thee, which shall proceed out of thy bowels, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build an house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. Now let's compare that with what David said in 1 Chronicles chapter 28. Which was obviously said before David slept with his fathers. 1 Chronicles 28, verses 4 to 7. Howbeit the Lord God of Israel chose me before all the house of my father to be king over Israel forever. For he hath chosen Judah to be the ruler, and of the house of Judah, the house of my father, and among the sons of my father he liked me to make me king over all Israel. And of all my sons, for the Lord hath given me many sons, he hath chosen Solomon, my son, to sit upon the throne of the kingdom of the Lord over Israel. And he said unto me, Solomon thy son, he shall build my house and my courts, for I have chosen him to be my son, and I will be his father. Moreover, I will establish his kingdom forever, if he be constant to do my commandments and my judgments as at this day. Said David. So Solomon goes on to build the counterfeit temple. He breaks the old covenant by whoring after other gods, as it is written in Scripture. He gets 666 talents of gold, the number of the beast. And according to Revelation 17:8, as I keep telling people, the beast was and is not. Just like dead Solomon, who is highly revered by Masons. Go figure. And is David's tomb really a holy place if old Jerusalem gets turned to heaps? Or is it more of a tourist trap for people who idolize a dead body that in time past had sex with Uriah's wife, which produced Solomon, who made a high place for child sacrifice abomination? 1 Kings 11:7, then did Solomon build an high place for Chemosh, the abomination of Moab, in the hill that is before Jerusalem, and for Molech, the abomination of the children of Ammon. Jeremiah 32:35, and they built the high places of Baal, which are in the valley of the son of Hinnom, to cause their sons and their daughters to pass through the fire unto Molech, which I commanded them not, neither came it into my mind that they should do this abomination to cause Judah to sin. And that's something that they tend to avoid teaching in so-called Sunday school, because, you know, they have these people that teach Sunday school, which is, you know, sun worship school. What is that? One day a week. It's not. I don't see anywhere in the Old or New Testament that says anything about, you know, the body of Christ gets together one time a week. You know, these people are sold out for personal interests. And you know, this whole thing about when David said that Solomon would build God's house and courts, well, these courts, like the Israeli Supreme Court I've talked about before, has everything to do with the court without the temple. Because these are Gentiles. By law, they're Gentiles. And I've talked about this before. Paul talked to the saints at Ephesus, and he said, remember when you were in time past Gentiles, because they were spiritually converted. And I've also mentioned before what's written in Romans 2:28 and 29 about what a real Jew is. It doesn't have anything to do with an outward circumcision. It has to do with those who are circumcised in the heart and in the spirit. And again, I say to people that God is not a racist. I do not believe that. There are certain people who some people consider to be Jewish, which is just a strange word to me, who have, you know, committed terrible crimes, you know, and they, you know, it's just ridiculous. You know, I just don't see how, you know, some people consider David Berkowitz, the son of Sam, murderer. What? That's not the way it works. I'm not blessed through him at all. My heart was circumcised in the spirit, and I was in time past a Gentile, just like Paul said to the saints at Ephesus. So I felt led to talk about this because people are seeing this, and I'm not saying that this person that did the video, is necessarily thinking the wrong things about some things or whatever. I'm not trying to trash him at all or whatever, but I'm just saying that there's a lot of people in the world, not singling out anyone in particular at this time, that think that holy mountain of God is that physical mountain. And it's not. I suggest, now I skipped over some verses in explaining these things when I left that comment, so I suggest to, you know, go back through, you know, read Hebrews 12 and read some of the other verses that I left. You know, I didn't leave them out to try to deceive anyone. I just left them out because I already wrote a long comment as it was. And you know, I don't want to put too many verses in there because it's just, you know, a lot of people just won't read them. I'm not saying the person that did the video, but I'm just saying that a lot of people just don't want to read that much information. So I try to condense it so, you know, it's easier for people to, you know, to take in. So this is what I was led to talk about today. Thank you.